Hi, my name is Jason Kang. I'm a full-stack developer working in South Korea. If you remember back to when we talked about the difference between front-end and back-end, I talked about the brand new iMac you see on the Apple website. The cool effects that you see, they are done by CSS. Those are some cool features that CSS has. As you interact with a web page by scrolling or clicking different elements, you get to see those effects. These are classified as transition or animation. They look very similar, but also very different in their core. They may look the same because both of them visualize proper changes. Maybe a button can change color, maybe a font can change, or also some might appear while others disappear. But they are also very different. Some major differences are, transition allows you to change state from initial state to final state, but nothing in between. But animation allows you to have some intermediate steps in between. For example, transition allows you to change the color from red to green, but will not let you change color from red to orange to blue to green. But animation can do that. With transition, if your color starts from the red, you can never go back to that red color. But animation can loop around. So if your color starts from red, you can go to red to orange to yellow to green and back to red. And transition has to be triggered by an event, maybe by hovering a mouse over or by clicking a button. But animation can be started on its own automatically. Let's look at this with some examples. First, let's start with transition. As you trigger by an event, so I'm gonna add a hover event to it to change the background color. And then the hover event. And you see the background color does not change unless I trigger it. So let's hover the mouse over. See the color changes, but it cannot go back to its original state unless I remove the mouse. Next one is animation. With animation, you gotta add the keyframes. You see how it's triggered automatically. And then you can add intermediate steps in between. You can see this one has the steps. And then it can also start from one and then go back. Like that. You can do a lot of things with animations. You can also use CSS along with some JavaScript event handling and allow some text to appear at certain points and disappear at another. But those are some topics that we can discuss later on. That's it. And as always, if you want to learn something specific, please leave them in the comments below so I can answer your questions. Thank you and stay tuned.